CNN. I told you right here when we first came on tonight that we're inducting a new member into the Grand Ole Opry, Bashful Brother Oswald. And that's everybody's reaction here. It's been a big yay tonight because he joins our official Grand Ole Opry family. And before he comes by to visit with Marty and I thought we'd go back to about 1955. Let you look at a little vintage Bashful Brother Oswald. Stay with us. We're coming back.
If I was on
that young man playing the dobro.
I don't know who that was.
Bashful somebody. Brother Oswald, Beecher Kirby, Pete Kirby, the newest member of the Grand Ole Opry as of tonight. The first thing I said to you when I saw you backstage tonight was, I thought you were already a member of the Opry.
Well, I thought it too. I thought I was.
How many years you been hanging around here?
I've been here 56 years.
56 years? They're just now getting around to making you a member?
Yeah. Takes them a little while, but that's all right.
Well, of course.
I waited.
You were here as a part of Roy Acuff's Smoky Mountain Boys for many, many years. Marty Stewart, what do you remember in your early years coming to the Opry and seeing this man on stage?
Well, I tell you what, he was one of the people. When I first got to the Opry, he treated me like I'd been around here for years and years. We always picked together. I played the mandolin, you know, and he'd let me in Roy's dressing room to pick with him. He always just treated me great, and this thrills me to death to see this happen. Pretty good audition, 56 years.
You got some correspondence from
you
some
You got
folks?
Some mail, brother.
Did I sure
You
not?
Got some Sorry. Mail.
Surprise me.
Listen here. Dear Brother Oswald, I'm so glad to see you finally have the opportunity to be inducted into one of the grandest families of all. Me and my family wish you the very best and wanted to let you know we couldn't be prouder. Your friend, Travis Tritt.
Well,
how about right. that?
Thank you, Travis.
Now, here's a man of many words, but it gets right to the point. Well, it's about time. Congratulations, Willie Nelson. And let me see.
That's old time friend, isn't it?
That's right. Dear Brother Oswald, I'd like to join the many others in congratulating you this special night. However, to me, you are the Grand Ole Opry, so welcome to where you've always been and where you belong. Thanks to you, Roy, and all the others for blazing such a beautiful trail for the rest of us to follow. Love, Dolly Parton.
Wow.
How about
nice
that?
Right. That's mighty nice.
Ain't that great?
I want to let the fans know something. Marty, I don't know if you were here the night. Bob Whitaker, our Grand Ole Opry general manager, called a meeting about 3 or 4 weeks ago of all the Opry stars between shows from 9 to 9:30. He wanted us all to go back in the television studio. None of us knew what the meeting was about. We thought, oh, we're fixing to get chewed out for something. See, so we all got back there, and everybody's very quiet. And Mr. Whitaker says, I wanted to tell you that we're about to name a new member to the Opry. And everybody just kind of went, you know, figuring it was one of the new young stars. And this jaded group of people who are used to people applauding for them, he said the newest member is going to be Bashful Brother Oswald. The entire cast applauded. It was the most beautiful thing. Everybody is so glad that you're here.
Well, when Whitaker called me in the office, him and Hal Durham talked to me, and I come out, after we got through talking, I come out to my wife. I said, let's go clean out my locker. She thought I'd been fired. Let's go clean out my locker.
When did you tell her the truth?
She knew I was lying because I had a grin.
There was a time on the TV show here on the network, The American Music Shop, where you two performed together. Mm-hmm. And you introduced Oz. We've got a clip of that. And you said some awfully nice things. Watch this on the monitor over here. And let's go back a few years to The American Music Shop.
Ladies and gentlemen, celebrating his 51st year in this show business, every year since 1939, when the curtain comes up at the Opry and you hear the Wabash Cannonball, here's the man who starts it, bashful brother Oswald.
Come on. He's here. Here he is.
I said, this is as far as I go.
Somebody said you felt like Elvis in there.
Oh, yeah. I did. I didn't look like him, but I felt like him.
Do you remember what you said when you got ready to leave? Because Rusty's told me this. He swears it's truth if he ever told it. Well, you know what you did?
No, what did I do?
He said you got ready at the end of the night when that show was over. He said Oz walked to the edge of the stage and all the other performers were out there and said you stood there and said, bashful brother Oswald has left the building.
That sounds like me.
You felt like Elvis, the king.
Again?
Well, you are the king here tonight.
He is the king.
Absolutely.
Right.
He sure is here tonight. We're going to go to the commercial break.
I wouldn't be no whore.
We're going to go to the commercial break with another look, a blast from the past here with bashful brother Oswald. You've sung good old Mountain Dew a few times, haven't you?
Oh, yeah.
You fixing to sing it again?
I probably will.
There you go.
Call it that old Mountain Dew, and if that refuse it, our cue. Do you need any help? Well, I can handle this job all by myself. They call it that old Mountain Dew, and if that refuse it, our cue.
Tennessee, she's long and she's tall. She came down to Birmingham on the Wabash Cannonball.
That's Oswald over there with the Hawaiian. Go ahead, horn whistle. Go ahead, whistle, Hawk.
Oh, that brings back a lot of memories. Bashful brother Oswald, for years part of Roy Acuff's Smoky Mountain Boys, tonight becoming a member of the Grand Ole Opry at 83 years of age. Charlie Collins has performed with bashful brother Oswald here ever since. Well, you performed together before Roy died, but after Mr. Roy passed away, then you really became an act together.
Yeah, Oswald and I had our own act in the Opryland Park also.
That's
and,
right.
Of course, KOA kept around. And, I don't know, maybe 13 years over there, and altogether, 28 years coming June, really.
Tell me something about this man that I don't know, Charlie.
Don't get him, Charlie.
I'll tell you, Bill, he's a great man to work with. He's the same every day. We had a lot of fun.
Is he funny off stage?
Oh, yes.
Does he do and say funny things?
Well, we're riding in the car sometimes. You come up with some good.
You want to talk about Charlie Collins?
No, I better not talk about it. Charlie's a good old boy.
Well, now, they're making Oz a member of the Opry, but Charlie, you're not actually being made a member, are you? But the act
no,
is still
not
together.
No, I know of. I wish I was, because it's a great honor, I'll tell you.
But you will continue together, though.
Oh, yes, right? yes. As long as Oz don't fire me, well, we're going to hang out.
No,
I told him last night, I said, I'm not going to let you fire me. We're going to hang together.
Oz, you want to plug your book, do you?
Oh, by all means.
That's really a good book. Bashful Brother Oswald, that's a truth if I ever told it. And I want to give the address, and I want you to listen close to the address if you want to order this book, because we had something happen last time. It's Bashful Brother Oswald, Post Office Box 1734, Madison, Tennessee, 37116. It's $15.95, and that includes postage. the letter I brought you, remember the lady that fussed at me because she'd ordered your book and didn't get it?
Yeah.
And she sent it to Madison, Wisconsin.
That's right.
It's a long way from Madison, Tennessee to Madison, Wisconsin. And the address is Madison, Tennessee, if you'd like this book and want to learn more about our friend Bashful Brother Oswald, who is becoming, I think they said, the 71st member of our Grand Ole Opry tonight. And we are so proud and so pleased to have you. As we welcome one guest, Palm Beach. I want to hear tonight from Bashful Brother Oswald, who's joining our Grand Ole Opry cast. I know you're tickled to death. I want to hear that famous laugh. Where did that come from? How'd you start doing that?
The old boy up home used to laugh like that. He weighed about 98 pounds, and that was his laugh. And I got to mocking him in the car. I'd do that, and Roy said, well, if you can make us boys laugh in the car, you ought to make the audience laugh. He said, use that on the stage once. I did, and it worked.
Become a trademark.
Yeah.
I read in your book that at one time you wore a red wig and blacked out your teeth on stage.
Oh, yeah, I sure did.
What was that all about?
Well, I didn't know how to dress, so I just put on a wig. And one night, there's a big bug got under my wig. I slapped my head like to try to kill that bug. And finally, I never did kill it. Finally, I just took the wig off and shook it down the floor like I didn't stomp it. Wig back on.
Well, Bashful Brother Oswald, Pete Kirby, on behalf of all country music fans everywhere and Grand Ole Opry fans, welcome officially to our Grand Ole Opry family.
Thank you, Bill.
As you join the cast tonight. We love you. We'll be watching you here live in just a few minutes on the stage with Marty Stewart, Porter Wagner, and Connie Smith when Grand Ole.
That was great, man.
Thank you, buddy.
You sang them. How long have you known Brother Oswald?
I've known him since I was 12 years old, and that's been, 8 years now, I guess it is. Now, I met him when I was 12 years old. I was in Missouri, and he and Roy Acuff, Smoky Mountain Boys, Jam Up and Honey, and Cousin Minnie Pearl played a show at my hometown, and I got acquainted with Oswald there, and I've known him all my career, so he's a wonderful man.
You and me have talked about it when we've had breakfast and talking about how everybody at this place loves Oswald.
They do.
He's like our granddaddy here.
That's right.
And we were talking about, I thought he was an Opry member, and we got to talking, and I'm so glad that we can all be here to help see this through tonight.
Me too. Thanks, friend.
Bashful Brother Oswald.
Gonna go home.
Well, all right. Well, after 56 years, you finally got it right. They're gonna let you stick around.
That's right, Porter.
Yeah.
I thought they were all going home.
Oz, I'm so very proud for you.
Thank you, sir.
And there's an old boy that's up in heaven tonight, I know he is too. He wanted you to be a member of the Grand Ole Opry, the guy you worked for all your career. I know he's very happy for you.
Yes, sir, I believe he would be.
I know he would.
We got a couple of letters from some proud folks out there in the nation.
All right.
Says, Dear Brother Oswald, I'm tremendously honored to have the opportunity to congratulate you on your formal induction into the Grand Ole Opry tonight. After 56 years of great performances, you certainly have more than earned the honor. And I know that millions of Americans join me in thanking you for the pioneering contribution you've made to country music and to our nation's musical heritage. Like many Tennesseans, I grew up listening to you and the other members of the Smoky Mountain Boys as you helped Roy Acuff and the Grand Ole Opry make country music one of the most popular and beloved parts of our lives. Your development of the dobro sound, your astonishing ability with the banjo, your mountain harmony singing, your success as a comedian, all of these and more have secured you a place in the hearts of everyone who loves country music and appreciates its roots. The stage of Grand Ole Opry has witnessed a long parade of the giants in country music, and for 56 years you've played an essential role in that procession. Brother Oswald, tonight you share in that rightful place alongside those giants. Thank you for sharing your talents with us, and may God bless you. Sincerely, Al Gore, Vice President of the United States.
Well, thank you.
And there's more. Porter, look at this one. That's got a nice headline on it, don't it?
It sure does. The White House.
Yeah. But it ain't from Clinton.
Makes it even better.
Wait a minute. Now, Porter.
I never said that.
I know it slipped out. I know how nervous you can get when you get inducted into the opera. You say things you don't mean sometimes. That just slipped out, too. This one says, Dear Brother Oswald, congratulations on your official induction into the Grand Ole Opry. I am pleased that the Grand Ole Opry is bestowing this important honor upon you, one of our nation's true musical legends. Country music is an exciting and distinctly American art form, touching audiences both old, young, urban, and rural. You can take great pride in your lifelong contributions to this rich tradition. Anyone who has ever experienced the peaks and valleys of life can find a sympathetic voice in one of your many wonderful songs. Best wishes for every future happiness. Who signed it, Porter?
Buddy, I ain't talking no more.
Bill Clinton, that's who signed it.
All right.
And we got one from the governor here, Porter. This is Bashful Brother Oswald Day in Tennessee. And it's Bashful Brother Oswald Day in Nashville from our mayor, Phil Bredesen. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please join us in welcoming our latest Grand Ole Opry member, the sex symbol of the Grand Ole Opry, Bashful Brother Oswald. There you go. Yes, sir. You get out of the way. Well, after all this hugging dies down, he's going to have to pick us one.
I know it, buddy. You're going to show us your stuff.
And I tell you one thing before we go any further. Come here, Charlie Collins. This is Oswald's picking and singing partner, one of the great Smoky Mountain boys, Charlie Collins. Yes, sir. Charlie, what are y'all going to pick for us tonight?
I think Oz is going to play a dobro number called the Isle of March, I believe.
All right, let's do it, Oz.
This got a little bit of the Honolulu Wiggle in it, you know.
Well, we're going to get off here, and we'll join him just in a few minutes later.
I about forgot how to do that, though. I might as well, as old as I am. We'll try to play it, though, for you.
About that? You wiggling pretty good there. Come here, don't go nowhere.
I ought to go, I guess.
No, we want you to do another song, but before we do, I want you to tell me, when I was driving by Music Valley Drive and I saw you sitting down there crying, what was the matter with you?
I cry a whole lot, you know.
I know.
But
you got a lot to be happy about tonight, though. You were crying today by that little boy.
There's a little boy sitting on the curb out there crying.
Uh-huh.
And I walked up to him and I said, "Sonny boy, what you crying for?" He said, "I'm crying because I can't do what the big boy do." And I sat down and cried with him. Man. Here.
What are you going to pick?
Oh, I'm going to ride back here.
Can I play one with you,
yes,
Charlie
sir.
And Billy? Let me get
you something. I doubt if you know this number. It's a brand new one.
What is it?
It's Mountain Dew. Here.
Bro, go.
It's over here.
Get it real fast and play me just a little bit. I'll be all smiles tonight. Would you do that?
Go ahead and tell him about me while I get it.
Well, he wants me to tell him about you. He's got a new book out. He's still writing songs. He told me last night his book was $15, but if you send him $30, he'd be happy to keep it. No wonder you got where you did. Come here.
It takes money to get up there like that. And that's the way to get it. What was you on me play? You're going to be with me, ain't you? That's in the key of D major, gentlemen. All right, here we go.
My brother Oswald.
I'll be all smile tonight.
Yeah. Marty Stewart.
Great time tonight at the Grand Ole Opry, have we not? Yes, we have. Thank you for joining us. We're going to do something right now. Got to get all the church choir together here. Get a brother Oswald to start us on one called the Wabash Cannonball. Mr. Jimmy Dickens, will you sing the first verse? And we'll see where it goes from there. Get it, Oz.
Yes, Danny Claxton, may his name forever stand and long be remembered in the courts throughout the land. His earthly race over and the curtains round him fall. We'll carry him home to victory on the Wabash Cannonball. Listen to the jingle, the rumble and the roar. as she glides along the woodland, up the hill and by the shore. Hear the mighty rush of the engine, hear that lonesome hobo's horn. He's traveling through the jungle on the Wabash Cannonball. Station, you could hear the people say, hey, there's a gal from Tennessee, she's long and she's tall, and she came down to Birmingham on the Wabash Cannonball. Listen to the jingle, the rumble and the roll, as she glides along the woodland, the hill and by the shore. Hear the mighty rush of the engine, hear that lonesome hobo's call. He's traveling through the jungle on the Wabash Cannonball. The wide Pacific shore, she glides along the woodland, the hill and by the